Quitting. The word's got a lot of baggage associated with it, and my advice around it is usually not to do it. But I might be changing my tune, at least a little bit. Drex here from Drex Factor Poi, sharing with you the love of poi spinning and flow arts to benefit your body and brain. And today, I want to talk a little about the moments when we persevere and the moments when we walk away. Before we dive in, I just want to give a quick shout out to the friends of the channel. Big thanks to Dark Monk, Flow DNA, Flow Fests, Flow Toys, Juggling Calling, Pyroterra Light Toys, Spin Balls, and Ultrapoi for helping to make the videos on this channel possible. You can learn more about all these amazing companies and the work that they're doing to support flow artists like yourself by checking out the links that I've got down in the description of this video. And a special thanks to the first non-business friend of the channel, Johnny Howard. Thanks so much for your support, Johnny. So this is coming up for me right now both because a YouTuber I'm a fan of, that is Izzy Harris, is stepping away from running her channel, as well as I've been having some complex feelings around quitting lately. A lot of people have asked me over the years whether I think it's appropriate to step away from a thing in order to gain some perspective on it. Whether I think stopping work on something will mean that when you come back to it, you get to make some real breakthroughs with it. And my answer is actually usually no. For most of my life, I've pursued things in such a way that as soon as the going got hard or I came to a spot where I got frustrated or not getting any better, that was a sign that I'd never get better and I'd lose interest and move on. That happened drawing comic books and portraits. This happened learning how to play guitar as well as with my old band back in Colorado. And then I read this amazing book called Mastery by a guy named George Leonard. In it, he talks about how we as a culture are somewhat accustomed to instant and immediate gratification, and because of that, we often wind up in a place where the moment something stops being exciting, we lose interest. We love the process of starting something new, buying the right equipment, making our first few gains, and thinking, oh wow, have I found my thing? And then we hit that dreaded plateau, and all the dopamine we're used to getting just drains out of the thing. The thrill of learning something new goes away, and we kind of miss it. Is this you? It was certainly me. And reading this book changed my life because it taught me a lesson that has been invaluable to me ever since. Accomplishment takes work. One of the biggest things I took away from reading that book was that regardless of whether you're feeling that thrill or not, if your ultimate goal is to attain fluency or proficiency at what you're working on, you have to show up to do the work. Constantly. I was kind of skeptical about this, but I thought, okay, well, I'll practice something regularly for several years and do so whether it feels exciting or not. I'll show up to do it every day and work to make the practice its own reward. By sheer random happenstance, the thing I decided to practice was a brand new skill that I'd only just started learning. Spoilers, it was poi. Yeah! So you can see how well that worked out. Especially as somebody who suffers from clinical depression, in which there are times when I physically cannot feel the dopamine rush of accomplishment, this information was kind of a game changer for me. And here's the thing, working on this didn't just become about the poi itself. As I got better and better at spinning poi, I started to realize I could apply those same techniques to other areas of my life too. Do you love the thrill of starting a new relationship and getting to know someone, only to find the day-to-day of it when the honeymoon phase wears off kind of tedious? I sure did. Do you love starting up a new job or career and feeling the rush of making an impact and how much your role is changing the game, only to get bored and burnt out when you settle in and find out how difficult the thing really is? Again, I sure did. Do you hop around to many different friendships, enjoying finding new interests, music, and hobbies with new people, only to be ready to move on once you've done the same thing over and over again with your new friends? Again, guilty. One of those things I learned through these techniques was not just how to become fluent at poi, but that the techniques for doing it, that is, doing the work day in and day out, were also the techniques for improving relationships, work, and friendships. And as a result of those lessons, I built longer-lasting relationships as well as the deepest friendships of my life. Plus which, I got ahead in a career that didn't even exist when I started spinning. To say nothing of when I started therapy and digging into who I was and why I was that person, showing up and doing the work day in and day out meant that I was able to make progress and learn new ways of being that have led to huge positive changes in my life since. So when I hear people say, take a step away from things and then come back later, part of what I hear is my own old mentality popping up, that the cure for lack of excitement is to do something else rather than putting in the work, no matter how tedious it may feel. But there is another side to that coin. Because as much as I had a bad tendency to jump from interest to interest in my life in hopes of always catching that fleeting rush of the new and novel, I also had a really bad tendency to stick with things that were bad for me. There's a long, long explanation for why this is that would take many videos to explain, but let's just say for right now that sometimes the familiar can be comforting and change can be terrifying, especially if you don't know what's waiting on the other side of that change. There have been many bad relationships that I've stayed with for far longer than I should have. Jobs that I knew on day one that I was miserable at, but I still stayed at for several years. Not because I was convinced that I had to keep showing up and doing the work, but because I was afraid to change. So watching Izzy Harris's video really struck a chord in me, because I am actually in a place in my life where I am in the process of quitting several things. There's a friend group that I had for years in DC that, for reasons I won't go into now, I've realized that I just don't really fit into anymore. And I've been kind of mourning the end of those friendships for a while now. But last week, I had kind of an epiphany and realized that what I was mourning was feeling comfortable. I was used to this thing, and moving beyond it was not only leaving me uncertain as to what friends I'd be hanging out with in the future, but also questioning and re-questioning whether I could hold on to those relationships, despite knowing that they weren't particularly good for me. So I finally just had a moment of thinking, I don't know what the next step looks like, but I'm going to figure it out. I'm going to find out what's right for me in this place in my life. And that was at once both scary as well as really cathartic. So, how is Poi different from leaving a group of friends, or in Izzy's case, stepping away from YouTube for a while? I don't actually know the full answer, to be honest with you. One thing I do know is that the time I spend with Poi or with my close friends is time that overall adds up to something that isn't just comfortable, but has a positive impact on my life. I can have friendships where even if we're arguing and upset with each other, we're still there supporting each other through life's slings and arrows. And even when I'm frustrated at not making any progress learning something new with Poi, spinning for an hour a day leaves me feeling better than when I started. So I think maybe what I'm getting at here is that it's helpful to find a balance and to identify where your motivation to either keep with something or move on from it is coming from. Are you sticking with something because it improves your life in some way, or are you sticking with it because of pressure from somebody else or even yourself? Do you want to move on from something because you're bored or because it leaves you feeling exhausted and worse about yourself? There's a lot of good reasons to quit things that aren't serving you. And there's a lot of reasons to stick with things that challenge you if it's in the right way. And the wisdom to tell the difference? Well, that's the work now, isn't it? Did you get anything out of this video? Pretty please, like, comment, share, and subscribe to help other people find it and to help my channel grow. I also just wanted to put out a huge thank you because this video would not be possible without the kind contributions of these wonderful folks right here. These are my Flow patrons on Patreon, and they, along with the wonderful people listed down in the description, help to make this video and all the videos on my channel possible. If you'd like to help me out in my mission to bring Poi spinning and flow arts to the wider world and help people learn to be creative with their brains and their bodies, you can do so by heading over to patreon.com/drexfactorpoi and signing up. You can get early access to all of my content, a say in what topics I tackle in the future, plus some great extras and behind-the-scenes content as well. So go check that out. Please and thank you. When do you know that it's time to move on from something? How do you determine that? Leave me a comment and let me know your own views on the matter. Be sure to check out some of my other vlogs on a variety of different topics on flow arts, culture, and mental health, and a ton more at the link down in the description or up on screen if you're watching me on YouTube. Be sure to get outside and flow today, and I will see you with a new video on Wednesday. Peace.